Hello, welcome to the tutorial video for self-service printing, or SSP. I'm Nicole Panditi, I'm a design technician at Jacobs Hall, and today I'm going to walk you through this new offering and how to use it. SSP is our new 3D printing program that allows you to send 3D prints remotely from anywhere. We are using a software called 3D Printer OS to manage the queue, and I'll show you a little bit about how to use that in this video as well. You're eligible for SSP if you're a student, faculty, or staff member at UC Berkeley. You will use the campus single sign-on portal to join. The second requirement is that you are able to be physically present at Jacobs Hall to pick up your part within 1 week of it printing. To access 3D Printer OS, go to this link. You will be asked to log on with your CalNet ID using the Berkeley single sign-on portal. Once you have logged in, you should be prompted to enter a workgroup code. You should enter the code corresponding with your academic college as listed in this table. If several colleges apply, please choose the college for which you expect to use 3D printing the most. If a dialog box does not appear, then on the dashboard page, click on the three dots at the top right and select Add Workgroup Printers. Input the code. Rules. The materials available are PLA with breakaway support. Only academic work should be submitted unless approved by a design specialist. Users' total print time will be limited to 20 hours per week or 10 prints per week, whichever is less. I recommend watching the Ultimaker 3D printer tutorial video in order to get more details about the 3D printing process. But the process of sending a 3D print consists of three parts: creating or obtaining a 3D model, slicing it, and sending it to the printer.
By uploading a file, a .stl file from your computer using the Add Files button right here. The second option is to actually create the file in 3D Printer OS by going to Create Design. This opens a 3D model builder, a very simplified 3D model builder, where you have the option of some basic shapes that you can scale and rotate and combine together, and then a fun little duck, because why not? Once you have a model file, it will be under your Files tab here. In order to advance it to your Projects tab, we're going to have to lay out, choose the layout, and then slice the file, which is digesting it so that the 3D printer can understand it. So let's see a file through the whole process. We'll go ahead and create a design. Let's just create a simple pyramid. We're going to select the correct printer. As you can see under My Printers, these are the printers that are actually available at Jacobs Hall. This is just a list of all the different types of supported printers. So choose from this list. We'll go Ultimaker 3, place it in the center of the build plate. I'll hit Place to Bed so that it's in a convenient location located on the build platform. And then I'll go ahead and save this file. So now that my file is here in the Files tab, we're going to do the layout and then slice it and print it. So the layout is where we do any moving, could do rotation. I'm not going to rotate it. This isn't an optimal spot, but I do recommend the optimal rotate function. This does generally find a good solid facet on which to place your object. We can scale it if you want it at a different size. And then once it looks good, we can proceed to slicing. So as you can see, the printers available are the printers that we have at Jacobs Hall. The Ultimaker 3 Extended is just a little bit taller. That's the only difference. So you can print taller objects. You'll see here under profiles, we have the option of different speeds. The different speeds are going to have pros and cons in terms of obviously faster printing, but then rougher surface finish. So that's up to you. And we don't need to bother with these because they are already set up. As you can see, extruder 1 is always PLA, extruder 2 is always breakaway support material, and that's not changeable. That's how the machines are set up. The main option that we have here is to generate support or not. In this case, this is not a shape that needs support. There's no part of this that is printing in midair or printing at a steep incline. But I always recommend clicking generate support, because if it's not needed, it won't be generated. And if you miss something, generate support will catch it, and then you won't have anything trying to print in midair. So let's go ahead. You can slice from here. You can also do slice in toolpath preview. I always recommend this if you're beginning 3D printing, because it's really good to understand how the machine is going to lay those layers down. As you can see, we've got our brim around here, and then we've got a shell that's being printed around the object and some triangular infill. So the inside is not fully filled in, which is what we want. And then that's how it's going to print. So that looks good. That's just another way to check before we actually send this to print. Now let's go ahead and print it. You'll be shown the printers that are available. You can select a printer by what color material it's printing, whatever color that you want, or you could just choose any printer if you don't care. And this part is very important. Do not hit the Q button. The Q button will place you in line indefinitely, and I'm not sure why anybody would want that in this case, as in a student makerspace. So we want you to hit the print button, and that's going to send your print immediately into the line. And whenever the print before it in line is done, it's going to print automatically. And that is what we want. So hit the print button, and now it's print.
To pick up your finished print, come to the first floor patio entrance to Jacobs Hall on the south side. These are the current pickup window times. You will receive an email when your print has finished and is ready for pickup. To give your feedback on this system, you can contact us here. Happy printing!